So I followed it down to the basement. Turns out it was my uncle.
I was waiting for it.
I guess it was actually my kid needing something to drink.
But you're the worst.
Kyle, we got some time. You were gracious enough to come and join us in this on this debacle. Yeah. But you've also, we talked about Chris's commercial. We've seen some people may have seen your face on some videos that have gone viral, been shared around mm-hmm. social media.
Speaking, that's right, Craig.
I've on used behalf it. Of veterans Famous and Amendment 2. Steve's used it a couple of times for his own pleasure. do me a favor, and it looks like you've been taking notes diligently, which why wouldn't you? You are in the presence of greatness. But man, like let the fans know who you are. What's up, man? Give us
okay.
Some.
Yeah, so I'll try to be brief. My name's Kyle, Kyle Kisner, of course. and I served the military for about 7 years. I joined between my junior and senior year. I was just really gung-ho about it. I was pretty fired up. I went to basic training in 2005, got done with AIT in 2006, got done with comp school in summer of 2006. Later that summer, I was going to Iraq. Come home from Iraq. I was home for about a year and 10 months maybe. And for about a year and a half of that time, I was doing military funeral honors detail with the Missouri Guard Honor Guard. And after that period, and then I went to Afghanistan. That's where I met Chris. And I come back. So we'll get you to where the story starts to get good. September 20th, 2010, we come home. And, you know, I was pretty dead set that I was going to move to Independence. I was going to go to the fire academy. I was going to become a firefighter and a paramedic. And I was, you know, despite the fact that I had serious pain in my hip and stuff like that, I pushed myself through the fire academy. Don't know how, because I was mostly fueled by booze and tramadol for that 4 month period. But so that kind of segues perfectly into the next thing. I started having issues with alcohol consumption. I started my pill intake was going up. Eventually I started losing jobs, getting in trouble with the law, had to move back with my mom for a little bit. While I was there, this is before I had done any kind of research of any kind, while I was there, I started considering the idea that, well, maybe I am taking a lot of pills every day, you know, because this is probably after about a year of being back and doing this, people are starting to, hey, you know, we're concerned about you kind of thing. So that started, well, you know, I know people use cannabis for cancer pain. Maybe this can help for my hip and my back, my knees. So I started trying to supplement a little bit. And well, I was staying at my mom's and she reacted the way most parents, you know, reacted a few, you know, 2012. And that was, you know, hey, you can't do this in my house. This is illegal. I'm not against it per se. It's just illegal and I can't take the risk. Understood. Well, I continued to do it anyways. And there's one day in particular, we got into a little bit of an argument. And it was over the pills and it was over the cannabis. She had flushed my stash, basically. I spent the last of my money on it. And, you know, she was just she's trying to take a hard line. You know, I hid your medication. Well, I came home. I was just in a whirlwind kind of rage and having that kind of acute moment of just screw this. I'm tired of this. I'm done. I'm just done. So I was at that point. I swallowed about 20 Percocets, 5 Xanax, about 10 Norcos, which are like Vicodins, but twice as strong. Only reason I'm even still alive is because my mom got off work 2 hours early that day. Came home, I was face down in a puddle of vomit, gray as a ghost. You know, she started saying, we need to get you help. I went to the hospital, was there, was on the psych ward for about a week. Come back, and I started doing 12-step AA. I'm doing all these other pills the VA wants to do with me. Fast forward to about 7 months later, I attempted a suicide again. By swallowing a whole bottle of morphine. Again, it miraculously, somehow my mom was able to get me come around the next morning. She took me down to the VA, went into treatment. I was in treatment for about 6 months, and, you know, I got pretty well squared away, but coming out, I was on more pills when I went in. So about late 2014, 2015 is when I really started dedicating myself to researching cannabis.
Are they weaning you off the pills when you're in rehab?
Not at this point. They're kind of.
Is it a VA rehab or what?
It is a VA.
They just rehab. Take one away and give you another one, probably.
Well, VA rehab. He's pretty much right. The VA. Yeah. They have two programs. They have a domiciliary program that has like 902 beds, and then they've got a 2 week, a 15 day program.
Yeah, 902 beds.
Just 900 beds.
Yeah, do the math on that
for the whole country.
They so have I was, 900.
And then most of the time they're not filled because they don't have the resources to fill those beds either. Right. So,
ooh, I did not know that.
So late 2000, I'm coming out. I'm on a bunch of pills, doing a little bit worse. So I started turning to cannabis, and the real turning point was when my mother, she caught me doing it again, and we had kind of a come to Jesus meeting, so to speak. And so, you know, look, this isn't about me having a good time. This is about me, because the stuff the VA is doing for me, the pills they got me on, this is not working. My whole reason for supporting this is because we're seeing 25% reductions in opioid overdoses. We're seeing reduced cost to prescription drug and Medicaid spending. We're seeing 11% reduction in the highest risk for suicide, males 18 to 29, and 9% about reduction in the next age bracket.
Those are huge moves.
Yeah.
Those are huge moves.
It's saving lives.
It is. So the point that I try to really drive home with people is, look, it isn't about, you know, Dr. Mishulam has a lot of research on exactly why it's the best. It's because we have more CB1 receptors, and it helps with a process called memory extinction. It helps you form new memories for the stimuluses that jack you up, you know, so loud noises, busy crowds, stuff like that. And they've got all these synthetics that are basically THC that they're saying these are medical, but then the real stuff isn't. Come on now. Patent 6 on our shirts right here, 6630507. You know, the government owns that patent on cannabis as medicine.
That's so wild. That's how it's illegal.
Yeah. At the end of the day, there's people that need this that are making some very tough life or death choices in a dark room somewhere, and they're not getting any help out of the hotline. The best way to say thank you this Veterans Day, don't buy someone a steak at Applebee's. Don't give them a beer. Vote yes on Amendment 2.
Damn.
Stand up. We stood up and served our country. You need to stand up and get out there and vote yes.
Kyle.
100%.
Wow. My man, Kyle. Hit that bell.
Wow, dude. Heck yeah, buddy.
Guys, thanks for entertaining us and educating us. And thanks to Chris Wolfenbarger. And thanks to you, Kyle. That was powerful, man. And Roman, I can see the emotion in your guys' eyes as you put that out there. The Missouri Medical Cannabis Conference was absolutely tremendous, and I'm a richer person for having attended. And I can't wait to go out Tuesday and vote yes on 2 and no on 3.
I'm with you,
and
brother.
No on C.
I'm with you, boys.
I've been waiting for a solid couple years for this. Our whole lives, we got a chance to go out and do the right thing. We want to thank our sponsors one last time, MoMed Canco. Check out MoMedCanCo.com. Enter HOSO at checkout. You'll get 15% off everything site-wide. James Carlton State Farm. Check out CarltonInsurance.net. Lifetime Roofing and Renovation. LifetimeSTL.com. And Tower Classic Tattooing and Parlor STL, which stamped Steve real good like. Guys, thanks for joining along. Get out there Tuesday, November 6th. Vote yes in 2 and no on 3 and C. We love you. Be well, Hoosiers.
Breathe the weed.
For months I got myself.